First of all, thank you very much for the invitation to this conference. I'm a co-founder and of an NGO that we publishers of open data, that we support freedom of information, practically let the people access to open data, decision making data and public spendings, for example. What I wanted to try to this evening to let you understand a bit more the last 25 years of the Hungarian history, and let me share some personal experiences with you. I'm 18 years old, in front of us an empty coffin, and the speaker said my my next 20 years laying in this in this coffin. So I was 18, full of expectation, and I didn't understand what the speaker, among others, what the speaker wanted to tell us with this sentence. Today I know, because this funeral was the Prime Minister Imre Nagy, after executed after the revolution, 1956, and the speaker was the young Orbán Viktor, in the name of the youngsters. And if you think about it, after 20 years, finally in 2010, Fidesz has that, won the two-thirds of the Hungarian parliament, and this 20 years of suffering was real. So he was absolutely right then. So I would like to tell about these years that the first I was a first voter that time. I was participating when Matyás Szűrös was declaring the Hungarian Republic. I was voting Hungarian Demokrata Forum party, who was the conservative side, and with others in coalition, they ruling make the first government. Prime Minister Antal said that this is a kamikaze government. It's this. He gives this name to this government because they have no choice to turn left or right direction. Just like they get on a train, and when the rail goes, they have to go there because they had to make several unpopular decisions, and that's why the next votings, the socialists and the liberals get the two-thirds, and the liberals was quite weird for me because they was the most anti-communist party before the first election, when the transition was started. So I thought that people live a bit more than the beginning of the transition, and that's why they hope that the socialists will take back the better times. But it wasn't true. Additionally, we got the Bokros package. It was a very huge and painful cut of the incomes, and now today know that it was the orthodox way of the avoiding a bankruptcy, but do exist an unorthodox way of avoiding a bankruptcy. What the Fidesz government did from 2010 till today. So according to the Bokros package, so it's this very painful cut. People were very sad, and the next government was the first Fidesz government in in Hungary, but they had to make the coalition with the Farmers Party, what was full of corruption. So it was not a nice job, and at the same time have no media at all. All the media was in the first 10 years was in the hand of the international companies. So the first Orbán government doesn't have any media support, and that's why in 2002 they lost the elections, and we elected a socialist party, and the socialist party made a government, and the prime minister was Mr. Medgyessy, a former secret police officer. So this was the done. We reached the deep of the bottom of the sea, I think. But the next, it was a very big scandal, and he quit with the so not fill the term, and Mr. Gyurcsány was the next. You would know about his speech about that laying around and not declaring the budget informations before the elections, and finally they won another term, so between 2006 and 2010, but finally Mr. Gyurcsány wasn't filled this term, and Mr. Bajnai came as a prime minister. But Fidesz, after losing this election 2002, realized that without media support, is impossible to win an election, and they started to build up an own media. It started in 2003. With the news TV, what is the CNN like, CNN style news TV about everyday issues and of course politicals. And later the Hungarian Nation was a daily, or a very old daily, connected to this brand. And in 2007, the Chainbridge Radio was this free media was the main supporter of Fidesz. And finally, in 2010, Fidesz has the two-thirds of the parliament. So between the 2006 and 2010, we had to pay the price. Hungarians had to pay the price for that in 2010 Fidesz and the Christian Democratic Party has enough power to make a new constitution to Hungary, and the first word is the Hungarian constitution is God. The first row is God bless the Hungarians. So imagine what the communists feel about it. So it was a really, really big. So they were fighting against these things. At the same time, Fidesz has stopped the money pumps, but what were operating in the Hungarian industry. There was some guaranteed market after privatization. Just an example. For example, there is a company who bought a Hungarian company what serves a water for the people, and the contract guaranteed 10% profit every year. So creative bookkeeping. They put all the additional costs to the bookkeeping, and end of the year, the price was raised to increase the 10%. So finally, it was double price than the the marketplace. And this all this guaranteed market was closed, and the sectoral taxes was used for keep the money in Hungary, not to send abroad. At the same time, the interest rate was going down. Now it's quite low, 0.9% or something like that. So it's for the economy is quite quite okay, because we Hungarian companies get loan, and this loan is not so high interest rate as before. I have to say about some problems that, for example, the double standard. After the elections, they won the first Fidesz government. There was several unfair attacks from the EU side about the constitution and so, just like the unruly rules of law against Poland, but there was a turning point. It was in 2012 January, when the peace march was organized, because then half a million Hungarian people go to the street and silently go through Budapest to assure the government that we are supporting you, and that was the turning point that that these attacks was disappeared. About the media issues in after the second win of the two-thirds in 2014, one oligarch, Mr. Simicska, was quit supporting Fidesz. And this oligarch has the ownership of News TV, Hungarian Nation, and Change Bridge Radio. What was the three main supporting media was for Fidesz, and from a day to another, they just stopped supporting, and Fidesz had to do something. This time they organized the public TV channel 1 to a news channel. It is, anyway, today it's a news channel, 24 hours. It is a Fidesz supporting media, and they have foreign language news, even Chinese. So it is a good, it's very very professional the way they do it. And now today, Fidesz and Mr. Orbán are organizing a new media support, because according to the Simicska's dissertation, and Hungarian Times, which is a newspaper, and TV2, what is a TV channel, and in the background they are buying some web portals, and somehow they reached, but legally it is a market operation, but the Népszabadság was stopped operation. You know, this Népszabadság was started in 1956 November, when the revolution was fought by the Russians. But after 60 years, Népszabadság is over. What is a quite symbolic thing in the media. Thank you for your attention.